Hi, and welcome to Edge Technologies. Today we're going to teach you how to install a guide channel set on a Patriot 338 and 551 bar feeder. In this tutorial, we will give you tips and tricks on installing the guide channel set. We will also show you the proper steps to safely install it in order to eliminate any harm between you and the bar feeder. The tools you will need are 3, 4, 5, and 10 millimeter hex Allen wrenches, your handle, 2 blocks of wood. For safety, we have a pair of gloves and safety glasses for protection. We will be using a 32 millimeter guide channel set and a standard length bar pusher for this installation. The guide channel set contains upper and lower channels, pre-feed pusher, support bracket, rotating tip, and bar pusher. Now that we have our tools and channel set, let's begin. For safety, we will want to engage both e-stops on the bar feeder. There's an e-stop on the pendant and one on the HMI. We also recommend to unplug the bar feeder as an extra safety measure. We also want to unplug the main air hose that connects to the bar feeder and also the black air hose that's connected to the bar feeder on the other side. If air pressure was in the machine, we will need to slide the support shaft towards the home position of the machine. This will give us access to the top guide channel assembly. For extra safety precaution, we're going to take a 4x4 and place it in between the two grippers and the guide channel support. This is a dangerous spot and can cause serious injury. If there aren't any 4x4s, you can use a remnant or any sort of material laying around. The bar feeder is now ready for the guide channels to be installed. Now that the bar feeder is ready, we can take a look at the guide channel set. The box will contain a sheet with an assembly drawing and a breakdown of what items are in the box. Each guide channel contains a CH and a 4-digit number next to it. These numbers correlate where the guide channels should go in the machine. Our first guide channel we will put in will be in the pre-feed location. This is the only guide channel that uses a 5mm socket for installation. There will be 2 fixed rings that need to be removed and set aside. Put them in a safe location so they won't get lost. The support pad is a safe place to put them. The pre-feed channel has a recessed opening for the support hanger. This opening should face the home position. Once we set the channel, we will put the fixed rings back in and tighten them. The next channel we put in, we use a 10mm socket wrench. We will use this wrench for the rest of the guide channels. We want to make sure that the pins are facing in the up and down position when we install the channel. There are aluminum batons lined up on the bottom of the magazine. These are used as the bottom guide channel support. If you're unable to tell the difference between the front and the back of the bottom guide channel, take a scale or a screwdriver, place it on the top of the back, and you'll see that the front has a small gap. That's your front. After we set the channel and the baton, take the 10mm wrench, insert it into the channel fitting, starting on the ends of the channel and then in the middle fitting. Rotate clockwise until the pins are locked in with the collet. If you are having trouble getting it in, wiggle it a little bit and move it clockwise. The corners of the channel should be chamfered to keep the pre-feed and the bar flags getting jammed up when the machine is operating. You'll want this facing towards the nose. The channel that was just chamfered has a special cutout for the chop channel support. You want to make sure that this is facing the nose end of the machine. The top channel is much more different than the bottom channel. You can tell by seeing a small step or lip on the top channel. This is your front facing. The next channels are the top guide channels. We want to make sure that the recessed lip is facing towards us when we install them. The next channel is the upper channel support for the bar. We want to make sure that the support is facing the nose of the machine. Now that we have our pre-feed guide channels installed, we're going to place a new block of wood in between the guide channels for safety and take out the 4x4 between the gripper.
This will give us access to the rest of the guide channels. Every Patriot has a 10mm Allen wrench provided to you for the machine. We'll use this for the rest of the tutorial. If you notice, we have been installing channels from one end of the machine to the next. This will prevent us from any confusion or potential jamming in the machine. For this guide channel, we want to chamfer it towards the home end in position to prevent any jamming. The top channel and the bottom channel that are at the nose of the position are shorter than the other guide channels. You want to make sure those are there. Now that our channels are in, let's jump to installing the bar pusher set. We want to take our handle and bring the chain adjustable block to line up with the opening. As we can see, there is a slot for the pre-feed flag and one for the pusher flag. Once our pusher flag is set, rotate the handle clockwise to line up the pre-feed slot with the opening. Using our 3mm wrench, we will insert the pre-feed flag and tighten the bolts up. If the handle gets jammed, take the handle out and place it between the pre-feed mechanism and the air cylinder and wedge the OAM block towards the nose position. After that, we will rotate the bar all the way past the hanger to bring down the top guide channel. Insert the hanger below the support plate and tighten the 3mm bolts up. Bring back the bar all the way back to home position. Using a 4mm Allen wrench, we want to make sure there is a gap between the bottom of the hanger support plate and the top of the pusher flag, about the thickness of a business card will work.
And that completes our tutorial on installing a guide channel set on a Patriot 338 and 551 bar feeder. Thank you, and have a nice day.